If somebody seems to be having normal levels of total testosterone, but abnormally low levels of free testosterone, can a therapy be provided with, say, an androgen mimicker that binds a lot to SHBG, has an affinity to SHBG? Would that sort of, in effect, release more free testosterone?
There's a couple of ways in which we can increase endogenous levels of testosterone through the inhibition of certain enzymes, such as aromatase inhibitor or aromatase enzyme or 5-alpha reductase. So overproduction of testosterone increases the amount of conversion to other hormones. So 5-alpha reductase catalyzes the reaction of testosterone turning into estrogen, and 5-alpha reductase, or aromatase rather, 5-alpha reductase then catalyzes the reaction of conversion of testosterone to DHT. And so one of the things that can happen is we can inhibit or slow down the actions of those enzymes, which will essentially decrease the amount of testosterone getting converted to those things. The other thing that we can do is there are some nutrients which will inhibit the binding of total testosterone to SHBG or to albumin for that matter, and that will actually result in an increased free testosterone within the same amount of testosterone that we already had. So testosterone levels may not go up, total testosterone levels may not go up, but free testosterone levels might.
So one could say that blocking the enzymes such as aromatase and 5-alpha reductase could increase total testosterone, whereas sort of binding to SHBG would increase free testosterone irrespective of whether total testosterone goes up or not. And that, yes, a strategy to block both would be great, because that would increase total testosterone as well as increase free testosterone.
Yeah, that's exactly right. So one of the misleading things in the testosterone boosting category is that increasing total testosterone actually has little effect. And so we see this go up, we see these numbers marketed, we see these numbers presented that total testosterone went up, and the general lay population will take that as, well, it's a testosterone booster, it increased my total testosterone. That actually has no real effect on the body because it's bound. And so by inhibiting, or not inhibiting, but by slowing down the action of the enzymes 5-alpha reductase and aromatase, you can increase total testosterone. If you can somehow then increase androgen receptor or increase the or limit the amount of binding that new amount of total testosterone has to SHBG, you essentially end up then with more free testosterone, more bioavailable testosterone.